home for good better best this morning. Jordy Kilby joining me. Thanks for all your texts, I know. This is now going to be your third last 7:45 a.m. bulletin. I appreciate all your texts this morning. It is. It's a big part of your day, I know. News time now. It's just coming up to 7:45. National Cabinet over bringing more Australians home. Serious coronavirus concerns over the surge in Europe and the Brumbies not taking anything for granted in tomorrow's grand final. ABC News, good morning, I'm Susan McDonald. Residents in Canberra's west are concerned the soil beneath their homes is contaminated by a petrol spill and are seeking legal advice. Sylvie Stewart reports.
The leak was discovered in an underground petrol tank at Caltex in Holt. Petrol's been leaking into surrounding soil since at least February. It's now contaminated groundwater. Caltex is investigating if the petrol has also contaminated soil beneath nearby apartments. It says there's no health risk to residents and that no homes have been damaged. Resident Lisa Mountford says she'll still seek legal advice.
We haven't had much communication at all.
The EPA has been notified.
ACT Labor says it will dedicate $15 million to the removal of hazardous materials in Canberra's public schools after a string of schools were found to have lead paint contamination. It matches a Liberal commitment, as Tom Lowry reports.
Yarralumla Primary, Alfred Deakin High School, North Ainslie Primary School and Curtin Primary have all had to close parts of their schools this year after lead paint was found. The Canberra Liberals have promised an infrastructure audit in all Canberra public schools should they win office next month. Labor has now promised a dedicated team in the Education Directorate to manage the issue, armed with $15 million in funding. It'll look for hazardous material and remove it. Labor says the funding is on top of the normal infrastructure and maintenance budgets.
State leaders will be under pressure from the Prime Minister to boost hotel quarantine capacity when National Cabinet meets today to discuss lifting a cap on international arrivals. Nor Hayder reports from Parliament House. The Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, has unilaterally declared that a cap on passengers into Australia will be lifted. For months, only 4,000 people have been allowed back into the country each week. The number was agreed to by National Cabinet in July to prevent hotel quarantine systems from becoming overwhelmed. Mr. Morrison says from next Friday, an extra 2,000 people will be let in on commercial flights, but not all affected states have agreed to the plan. Mr. Morrison argues there are plenty of spare hotel rooms in capital cities and ABS support will be available. The ABC can reveal an American university with $16.5 billion in annual revenue received a JobKeeper payment for its Sydney campus while local universities missed out. National education reporter Connor Duffy.
New York University is an elite institution with outposts all over the world. The ABC can reveal staff at NYU's Sydney campus were able to access the JobKeeper program. The move is likely to infuriate Australian universities where casual staff are being let go in their thousands. Green Senator Maureen Faruqi says it's a double standard.
This government, again and again, changed schools.
In a statement, Treasurer Josh Frydenberg says he could not comment on the tax affairs of an individual JobKeeper recipient, but all universities were eligible if revenue.